Now, I'm proud that our Unitarian Universalist Association, as well as our church, is in the forefront of immigration reform. At our last General Assembly, we decided that immigration as a moral issue would be a study action issue for the next 4 years. And we've decided that in this church as well, immigration is going to be our top social justice issue for at least this next year. And Reverend Carlton will be leading a discussion on a book called Making Immigration Right to help us to do that. An action of immediate witness was also passed to oppose anti-immigrant measures in Arizona and other states and to hasten federal immigration reform. And we decided that our General Assembly in June 2012, which is scheduled for Phoenix, will be a justice GA, where as a denomination, we will witness for immigration reform and other justice issues. Our congregation is also committed to stand on the side of love when it comes to immigration reform, realizing that relationship is the most effective tool for social justice work. We have entered into relationships with those in power, those in our community, and those in our faith to bring about what Dr. King called the beloved community. Through our leadership and voice, Virginians Organized for Interfaith Community Engagement, we are seeking to reduce the unacceptable backlogs in processing applications of legal immigrants in our area. And we are working with elected officials to pass comprehensive immigration reform in our state. Through our Northern Virginia Legislative UU Priorities Group, we call LOOP, we are preparing to fight a bill that will turn our state into another Arizona, harassing people of color and making it illegal to support and aid undocumented immigrants in any way. We have also been developing a relationship with our neighborhood Buckingham immigrant community. By sponsoring accompaniers in Guatemala to help safeguard human rights, we have come to know the immigrants in our community, many of whom are from Guatemala. We're also helping to pay for the education of Mayan high school students in Guatemala. And our Buckingham Outreach Committee has opened the doors of our church numerous times to our neighborhood, sponsoring dinners, concerts, and lectures. 2 years ago, a group from our church traveled to Guatemala on a just journey sponsored by the Unitarian Universalist Service Committee. We learned then about the murder of more than 200,000 civilians by the military during the 1980s and 90s, and the continued human rights abuses. This trip gave us a sense of what many of the immigrants in our area have experienced and the political and economic reasons for their coming to this country. And in 2 weeks, with your blessing, 12 of us from UUCA, including myself, will return to Guatemala to learn more about that nation's political struggle. And one of our stops, and this is going to be particularly exciting, will be the town of Concepcion. And this is the town where many of the Guatemalan immigrants here in Buckingham come from. So we'll be able to see their hometown and learn about that. And we hope to return with a commitment to use what we learn to build better bridges of understanding with immigrants and to work for effective reform. And we're going to share our reflections and experiences with all of you on Sunday, November 14th. I hope you'll be there. And if you're going on that trip, can you please stand so this congregation can bless you on the journey? I know some of you were in the earlier service, and here are a few from this service. Let's hear them. Now, as you can see, we're doing a great deal to reach out to the immigrants in our community, to learn from their rich culture, and to support them in their struggle for human rights. And I hope all of you will join in that effort. But realize, this is not just a political issue, this is a spiritual and moral issue. We are recognizing that we are our brothers and sisters' keepers. In every age, there are those who are persecuted for their differences, and it's the duty of those who are willing to listen to their conscience, as well as to the dictates from every religion on our planet, to stand on the side of love. And let me share an example given by Karen Musala, while acting director of the International Human Rights Clinic. She tells a story you may have heard before, but it's worth repeating. It's a story of a Japanese diplomat, Chiyun Sugihara, who was assigned to his country's consulate in Lithuania in the early 1940s. Jews who fled from Poland into Lithuania needed permission to pass through the Soviet Union and Japan in order to continue to other destinations. One day, not long after he took up his post, he found 300 desperate people, some who had walked all the way from Poland, standing outside his consulate, begging for help. He had already been officially forbidden to help any Jew seeking to escape the Nazis. He knew to act was to endanger not only his own life, but the lives of his family. He made his decision after consulting with his family and listening to his five-year-old son, who asked, "If we don't help them, won't they die?" Before his arrest and deportation, Sugihara issued more than 2,000 exit visas because he listened to his own conscience. Today, there are an estimated 50,000 people who claim descent from what are called Sugihara's Jews. May each of us have the courage to listen to our conscience and to stand on the side of love, welcoming the stranger in our midst and working for life-saving immigration reform. Do I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Especially those called strangers and immigrants. And may we feel their presence in this circle and open our hearts to them and welcome. Shalom, salam, blessed be, and namaste.